There's a lot of gold still out there. We're in the middle of a modern day gold rush right now. And if you can just get out, find it, you can become a rich person.
I've made thousands of dollars in locations all over North America, but I'm still looking for one big find.
I have an amazing family. I love them dearly. My job as a hospital security guard provides an okay living, but I want to set me and my family up for life. I know I've got the knowledge and the skill as a miner to go find big gold. So that's why I'm headed into Devil's Canyon.
Devil's Canyon is one of those places that you hear about in the mining community. Everybody talks about it. The gold up here is crazy. And when I walk out of here, I'm hoping I can barely walk because my pack's too heavy with gold. The problem is, everything out here is designed to beat you down. If the weather don't get you, the animals will. If the animals don't get you, the canyon will get you. It doesn't want you to take the gold out of it.
That's why so many people feel Devil's Canyon is cursed. Legend has it for every 100 men that enter this canyon, 90 men go home empty-handed. One goes home with the gold, and the rest go home in a box. When the gold rush started here in British Columbia in 1858, 30,000 prospectors hiked into this area looking for gold. The next year, only 3,000 remained. Between bad superstition, bears, the weather, the lack of food, it's a hard place to survive. But if you do, you can make some serious money out here.
Just getting in to the area where I want to start working is, it's backbreaking. There aren't any trails out here. So I'm carrying everything in. Everything is coming in on my back. So I had to make strategic decisions.
I decided to pack only the bare essentials of mining and survival equipment. That gave me the extra room in my pack so I could carry more food.
My pack's gotta be pushing 130 pounds. Just doing that is dangerous. One wrong step, I roll an ankle. Who's out here to save me?
It's time to prospect. If I can dig up maybe 3-4 ounces, that will go a long way for my family, take care of a lot of bills. There's also a chance while I'm out here, I could hit the jackpot.
Right, so here's what I'm guessing, is I've got a huge depression in here. It's an ancient river channel. I'm gonna try and dig that out.
An ancient river channel is the remains of a river that's been diverted due to some geological event like an earthquake. At one point in the past, this river may have carried gold from its source called the Motherlode and deposited the gold along the riverbed. Over time, the river channel becomes hidden under layers of dirt, but the gold is still there, waiting to be found. The first thing that I'm going to do is take some test pans to see if there's any gold in this spot. If there is, then I'll set up to really dig this channel out. Panning separates the gold from all the dirt around it. I'm adding water to the pan and rinsing the material. The heavier items, like gold, are going to sink to the bottom of the pan. Once that's done, you remove the rocks, and then you start easing water across the lighter material that's left. Just slowly working it down off the top. The heavier gold will stay put on the top of the pan. You just roll the water back and forth, slowly getting rid of the sand and the dirt.
Some real, real small stuff. It's not good gold, but move enough dirt and get a whole bunch of that, that can be good gold.
I need to find stuff that's got chunk to it, some consistency. I'm gonna look for a place where the gold that flowed down this river would accumulate.
I got 6 weeks out here before winter hits, so I have to get busy and find a site that can cough up some serious gold.
So I'm gonna work my way down here, doing some more pans. I've got a really hard, hard bend over there that if gold was moving down, it'd get jammed up in that one pocket there. So just hoping I can find a pay streak in here somewhere.
My heart's on gold. There's just something about that gold
that keeps pulling you out there. You just want to keep digging. You want to keep getting after it.
There we go.
When you get that gold fever, you're hooked. It's like a bad disease.
All right, got my first piece of decent color, but just after a couple of test pans, starting to understand a little bit more about how the gold moves around here.
One way or another, if it's here, I'll get it. These clouds coming in. Something nasty's heading my way. I can almost smell rain. What I need to do is get a fire going before the rain starts. I gotta get some decent wood for it, so I'm gonna head over to this deadfall that looks fairly recent. But the branches on it look like they've been drying out for God knows how long. Great for kindling. That, along with all the wood that's around my camp, I should be all set. Fire tonight is gonna be essential, not only for warmth, but it'll help keep the bears away. Bears generally feed and are most active around dawn and dusk periods, so I'd really like to get that fire going before nightfall. I'm tired, I'm hungry, gotta get fire started. It's gonna be absolutely freezing tonight. I've gotta get moving. This is a dryer lint full of dog hair, people hair. This stuff goes up like a torch. Using a ferro rod to start this fire.
Come on.
It's essentially magnesium. You drag a piece of metal across the top of it. The two metals combine and create a very large spark.
Shoot, it's wood. All it does really is smolder.
Made fire everywhere, in the deserts, high mountains, Sierra Nevadas, absolute crap weather. There's just something about this area that wants to just fight back against you on everything.
First, start raining.
That's the more like it.